Finally!
Hey guys, finally the long awaited Creta's full review has come, and today I'm gonna tell you how was my experience in the last 10 months since I purchased it, and what are its great features that make it the fastest and highest selling car in the segment. So now let's go for a drive. The best part of having a Hyundai Creta in your garage is when you start your day and you de-park your car from your parking lot. It's very convenient and easy.
It has been winning hearts of majority of SUV lovers since it was launched due to its appearance and richness. The interior is most plush in this segment and is equipped with comfort and convenience. The Hyundai Creta was launched in 2015 and it has only seen rapid growth in the sales, and I am here to tell you why. It is still one of the highest selling cars in India today. Let's first take a look at the exteriors. It has this attractive set of headlamps including DRL and projectors, and the fog lamps are large enough to illuminate your path well. The very muscular and rich chrome grille with 3 blades to cut the rivals into pieces. Also, it gets a good looking touch with the front diffuser. But everyone's favorite is its 17-inch 5 double spoke alloy wheels that look superior when running. The two-tone body colored ORVMs have turn indicators in front and back. They're very useful while you're overtaking.
The SX Plus option model comes with chrome handles as well, and it has a keyless entry.
On the rear, the car is very beautiful with its tail lamps that start from the shoulder line and go all the way to the tailgate. The sober chrome garnishing on the tailgate looks very attractive and complements the car's charm from behind while hiding the reverse parking camera in it. Lastly, the reflectors in the bottom combined with the diffusers give it a great finishing. They also include the reverse parking sensors. It has a rear wash wiper and there is a shark tail antenna to add up to the looks while keeping you connected to the FM as well as the GPS.
Now let's check out how it looks from the inside. Now starting with the steering wheel, it has a multifunctional hydraulic steering wheel which has controls for the music as well as for the trip and MID you have there.
Here you have the volume controls as well as the call buttons, and on the right side you have the trip controls.
It also has a tilt adjustment, so based on your height you can adjust it that way. Talking about the climate control, it has an automated blower along with cooling and heating functionality. It cools very rapidly and I have noticed it many times in the hot summer of Nagpur. Right about the climate control, we have the infotainment system which has a 7-inch touchscreen display that also comes equipped with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, and it also has an inbuilt satellite GPS system which gives you great telematics navigation. There's a digital clock about that. This car comes with 6 speakers which gives you a great sound quality as well.
Looking at the glove box, it is quite spacious and sufficient to hold your docks and small accessories. The sun visor on the passenger side has a vanity mirror without a lamp.
The seating is quite comfortable and I have enough headroom and legroom in front of me. I am 6 feet tall and when I adjust my seat in position according to my height, we'll see how much space is available for the rear passengers behind me. Seats recline really well. Here we have a fixed armrest which has storage space as well. Attached to it is the parking brake. There are two bottle holders in here. This car came equipped with a 6-speed manual transmission which is very smooth to drive. I get very smooth gear shifting while driving on high speeds and it is very reliable for me. Looking at the ports, car has 12 volt charging socket as well as a USB port to connect your smartphone for Android Auto or Apple CarPlay. Also, it has an aux port for music playback. The aux port has vanished from the new Creta. However, I still have it because it's the old one.
Very close to the steering wheel, we have the push start stop function.
On the right side, we have the headlight setting as well as some blank switches and the ORVM control. So if you want to you can electrically adjust your mirror accordingly.
The door has the electric mirror control as well as the window controls.
Driver's window has an automatic switch with anti-pinch.
And a bottle holder and some magazine holders. Quite a storage and spacious car.
This car obviously comes with central locking that has controls on the driver's door and a child lock for the rear windows.
It also has a dead pedal.
The dashboard has 4 AC vents for the front passengers and 2 AC vents for the rear passengers.
On the dashboard, you also have the defoggers to clean your windshield on a rainy day. Here you have the wiper controls. And on the right, you have the headlight controls.
Sitting in the back seat is also very comfortable when I have adjusted the front seat as per my height, which is 6 feet. I still get enough legroom for me and also decent amount of headroom. This seat can settle 2 adults and 1 child easily. And if you want to settle 3 people, they will feel a little congested, however, not very uncomfortable. You also have a rear armrest that comes with 2 bottle holders. There are seat belts for the rear passengers as well.
There is also a rear boot tray to settle your extra belongings while you're traveling.
Rear seats are foldable, so you can increase the boot space whenever you need.
Now let's take a look at the boot. Just as the front doors, the boot also has sensors, so if you have the keys in your pocket, just have to press the button on the boot and it will open up hydraulically. The boot is quite spacious and you can increase the space by removing the front tray. Inside the boot, you get your full-size spare wheel along with the tools to help you with changing the spare wheel. I have never taken this out because I had opted for tire protector in all 4 of my wheels, so I never got to notice the puncture. Also, I only use nitrogen gas in all 4 of my wheels, so I don't have to refill the air more than once a month. This leather carpeting was optional. Now, when you close the boot, it will automatically lock the entire car again.
That was a quick overview of how the car looks from the inside and the outside. Now is the time to take it on a drive and we'll start from the congested areas first, so that you can know how it drives when you take it to a congested street. We initiate with one of the Nagpur's most congested areas where I drive very often to see a friend, and surprising everyone else, Creta gives me confidence to drive here very easily.
Although it has a huge size, it's one of the bulkiest compact SUV in the segment. It doesn't end up giving you trouble while you want to drive it in the congested areas. When you're driving through congested areas, congested streets, it is still good to go. I spend hours in traffic a lot of times in the city because Nagpur city is full of traffic these days due to the metro construction work. Also, a lot of areas in Nagpur are getting new cement roads, so congested roads are almost everywhere. And this car actually gives me a great comfort and great ride quality in those city conditions. Fuel economy still is not that bad. The best part of driving a Creta is its road presence. When you are on the road, you will notice that a lot of people pay great attention to your car and make way for you. Waiting in the city traffic for the signals to open isn't that big of a hassle because we have a great music system with us which gives you a good sound quality. Thank you.
sitting position is certainly very high in this car comparing to other cars in the segment, which gives you great visibility on the road, also gives you a great feel of riding a nice SUV. Long trip in Creta is also not a big deal. SUVs are meant to be on the roads, on the highways, on the long journeys, and Creta is never behind. I have a personal experience of driving this Creta in Nagpur to Pune journey as well as in Nagpur to Indore journey. When I was traveling from Nagpur to Indore, it took me around 10 hours of non-stop driving. And the great part is that journey wasn't very tiring. In fact, I had a great time driving this car on the road. The highways had a variety of roads. Obviously, there were trucks, rash drivers everywhere. However, Creta handled everything very well. And it did not require a lot of my efforts to handle that pain. Well, if you ask me, what is my favorite feature about the Hyundai Creta is its horn. Take a listen. This is actually very loud, it's a pressure horn. Although in the city, it might get irritating to some people, so you have to use it very wisely. However, when required, it is always there for you. It helps you cut the traffic sooner. Also, it is a very useful thing on the highway. In the city traffic, most problems are the potholes. A lot of areas in the city roads do have giant potholes. But the great part about Creta is its seats are so cushy and comfortable. I get the feeling of sitting on a lounge. Not like a high-end luxury SUV, but still it's best in the segment. So getting irritated in the traffic while on the Creta is the last thing you should worry about. But the key element in giving a good ride quality to Hyundai Creta is its hydraulic steering, which gives you an ultimate ride quality at low speeds as well as in the high speeds. When you're driving your Creta on the highway, you're cruising at around 80 to 100 km of speed, your steering automatically gets heavier to keep you from losing your control. The climate control which we get with the Creta is also very nice. It cools your car very rapidly and gives a very comfortable feeling. Since Nagpur is a very hot city, I opted for an additional accessory that was a tinted glass. I opted for tinted films in all the glasses that I have in the Creta, which avoid excessive heating of the car on a sunny day. Overtaking, wow. When you want to overtake quickly, it gives you power on the demand, which is a very great feature about the Creta. And the braking, of course. The AB system and EB together work really great. They give you a little feel on the pedal as well, however, they're very reliable. While driving from Nagpur to Pune, I had to face a lot of bad roads which were under construction and had a lot of potholes. Not just little potholes, they were rough roads as well as no roads. And when you suddenly notice a large pothole on front of you have to suddenly brake your car, and the ABS is very reliable at that situation. For those of you who want to know why and how I chose to buy a Creta is, see, I was a car enthusiast for many years and I was unable to decide what car would suit me the best because I had test driven a lot of cars and a lot of them felt great to me. However, that feeling was missing which could make me buy a car. So after trying 20 to 25 cars, I finally got to choose a Creta. Why? Because it suited my height well. The driving style which I carry requires me to sit a little away from the steering wheel because of my height is 6 feet. So the sitting posture which I get to carry fits best in the Creta. And then the driving style which made me feel that Creta and me are made for each other. The power delivery, the sitting posture, the ride quality, the reliability, the braking, music system, everything was a perfect bunch of features which made me feel that Creta is something that I should buy immediately. And the day I got the Creta delivered to me became the best and most memorable day of my life. And I have never regretted buying a Creta since then. Nagpur is, by the way, not a very large city. However, when you want to travel from one corner to another, you take at least 30 to 35 minutes. And those 30 to 35 minutes are actually enjoyable because of the ride quality in this car. It's a 5-seater SUV and it comfortably settles 5 people for that matter. The ORVMs on both sides are large enough so I can get a great view of all the people who are behind me. There is a very little blind spot which is quite negligible because center mirror also works very well. Talking about the center mirror, it is manually operable for night dimming. It is not electric. However, the new Creta 2019 has an SXO model which comes with an electric chromic mirror. The manual one is also not that bad.
Honestly speaking, with my Creta, I overtake so much on the highway, I don't often see other cars coming close to me from behind. It's an executive's car and gives you a business appearance wherever you take it. Take a look at the quick comparison between Creta and its close rivals such as Justo, Jeep Compass, Tata Harrier, Kicks and Captur.
It has a great turning radius as well. You would notice that I'm only driving it with one hand most of the time, that is my habit. And this habit is only fulfilled by cars like a Creta, because most cars which actually do not have a hydraulic steering wheel would require an extra effort from the driver. Although there are electric power steering wheels in other cars, they don't give you that much of confidence like the Creta does. Potholes everywhere in the city. As I said, I don't usually get to feel the potholes. Why? Because Creta comes with 17-inch large and fat tires, which give you a feel of only the larger potholes and not the smaller ones. You would usually feel a little vibration in the bad road conditions, however, not a bad ride quality at least. Power delivery is also very dynamic, so when you're driving it in the highways, when you're trying to take over, it maneuvers very quickly and there is absolutely no lagging there. The reason behind why it has such a good power is its torque, which is 270 Nm. The 1.6 liter petrol engine which I am driving is actually very powerful and it delivers power on demand.
Now let's take it for an off-road. The car is equipped with superior suspensions that provide utmost comfort in most situations. Additionally, the car's large wheels and powerful torque allow you to go through bad roads without a hassle. Although it's not a 4x4, it's very practical to take on the usual Indian roads and rural areas where you don't get well-constructed roads to drive. Now, let's see the lights in the dark. Those are the tail lamps and now the brake lamps. From the front, the DRLs and the fog lamps. Low beam and high beam projectors. Take a look at the cornering lamps that run when you turn. The headlamp unit is so beautifully placed and looks attractive even at night. I love looking at it every night when I park. This is the blue illumination in the cabin at night.
Not to forget, it has a great infotainment system with a 7-inch touchscreen display which offers you inbuilt GPS navigation as well as Apple CarPlay with Android Auto. I have an Apple iPhone, so using an Apple CarPlay is my daily thing. I get my contacts synchronized with it, I get messages and other notifications on the screen. Although the notifications are hidden because that is my phone setting, so you don't have to worry about other people who are traveling with you who can see the notifications themselves as well. Taking calls while driving is also a great thing. And I also get to operate Siri in my iPhone using this call button on the steering wheel, which is very convenient because I usually want to call people without having to touch my phone. And this thing is very helpful for me.
Now take a look at the display quality when you play HD videos and when your car is not running. Finally, the MID that shows you the RPM and your analog speedometer. On the center, you have the two trip meters. It shows you your fuel and oil levels. It also shows you the average speed, total mileage, and the outside temperature. It also indicates seat belt and handbrake, headlights, and turn indicators. When you take the key out with engine on, it'll also indicate key out and will make a beep sound. As a bonus, I'll show you some of the best pictures that I've shot by now.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching the video. If you liked it, please remember to like, share and subscribe. Also in the comments, tell me how you like this video and how much you like the Creta on road. I know you all are waiting to see the new 2019 Creta, which has the ventilated seat, and that is also about to come, so stay tuned with me and remember to join me on the social media. The links are in the description. Until next video, goodbye and drive safe.